Welcome to Thanatology Up-to-Date. Today's topic probably deals with the most outstanding aspect of near-death experiences, namely out-of-body experiences. There are people who are close to death and have the feeling that they're outside of their body all of a sudden. And this is what we will talk about today. My interview partner is Dr. Eberhard Rast, a physician and the president of Swiss Irons, a society dealing with the causes of near-death experiences. Dr. Eberhard, how often do these out-of-body experiences occur? Are they a part of every near-death experience?
We are certain that out-of-body experiences don't occur during every near-death experience. However, it is one of the most frequent elements of a near-death experience. They are usually smaller studies, and they all have different stats, but the numbers range from 30 to 90% per study, so it definitely happens frequently.
Under which circumstances does such an experience occur? Are there people that are more prone to have such an experience than others, so that they have a sort of disposition?
As far as I know, no. So we can't even predict who will have a near-death experience under the same circumstances, and you can't predict which elements will be experienced either. One of these elements are out-of-body experiences. So we can't really talk about disposition here. It seems there are people who can produce out-of-body experiences without having a near-death experience. And a sad topic is that especially children who have been abused sexually or physically, or who've experienced a lot of violence, that they develop this ability to leave their body as a form of protection. This has also been reported by adults who had out-of-body experiences while they were tortured. And it seems at least there is one study that seems to point towards this, that children who've had an out-of-body experience and then a near-death experience, that they also have had an out-of-body experience more frequently during their near-death experience.
One explanation of out-of-body experiences is the stimulation of certain areas in the brain. Apparently, during experiments, scientists managed to provoke out-of-body experiences through the stimulation of the temporal lobe. Is this a satisfying step towards an explanation?
No, not yet, because it's relatively clear that what they were able to produce was an illusion. They also partially arranged the study in such a way. Just imagine somebody puts a screen in front of you where you watch how you see yourself from behind, because the camera is pointing at your back. And then they do experiments with you where they touch you, but they also move something towards the camera. So you have the illusion that you're outside of your body and you're watching yourself. It's not surprising. It's practically just a sensory delusion. Stimulations of the temporal lobes are a different story. They are the lobes near your temple, and there's the theory that it is a discharge of epilepsy in those zones which can produce these strong illusions, a sort of physical distortion of the self, of the physical awareness. This was already found out in the 1950s, that due to such stimulations of these zones, you can have the feeling that you're outside of your body, a sort of dissociation, as it is called in psychiatry. But also here, the relevant difference up till now has been that these people get the feeling, and they also find it uncomfortable, that they don't seem to be in their body anymore. They're floating down or up at that moment, but they're aware of this, and they don't see themselves at the same time, as it is the case in near-death experiences. And this seems to be the deciding factor whether it is an out-of-body experience. People report that they actually look down at themselves, and this isn't the case of people who've participated in these studies, because they cannot report what it looks like down there. And apparently, that's what the others are able to do. At least they perceive it that way, so there really seems to be a difference.
Are there known cases where something that somebody had reported could be verified by the people concerned? For example, when somebody experiences his or her reanimation from above, that the doctors were able to verify what had happened there?
Well, there are numerous anecdotes like these. They repeat themselves very often. There'd been done one study regarding this question. During this study, Michael Sutton, a cardiologist, asked reanimated people who hadn't had a near-death experience, "How do you imagine your reanimation? Please describe this event." and other people who were asked had had a near-death experience and possibly an out-of-body experience. So this difference was very relevant. Some people were able to report many details and others couldn't report any. What I mean is that these out-of-body experiences seem to be real. There is also Sampania's last study. He installed some boxes at intensive care wards, where many reanimations were taking place in the United States of America, England, and Austria. And the content of these boxes could only be seen from above. And he was hopeful that some patients would have an out-of-body experience during a near-death experience, and that they would steer their attention towards this box and would report about it. And then it would have been clear. So, there were many reanimations, but only 300 out of 2,000 survived. I would say this reflects the norm, and the ones that had this out-of-body experience were reanimated outside of this zone. Finally, out of these 2,000 people, there was one case with an out-of-body experience. He was able to describe what had been going on and these were things that had really happened, but he didn't describe the box. Insofar, we will eventually find the key and we'll be able to say, yes, it's definitely been proven. However, we haven't managed this up until now, so these are things that just stay anecdotes.
For you personally, what's the most likely explanation for these out-of-body experiences?
In my opinion, our consciousness actually leaves the body. There are many indications and aspects which go way beyond this. It starts with that near-death experiences with out-of-body experiences are very complex, although in many cases, the brain couldn't have functioned anymore. At least what we know now is that the part of the brain that produces consciousness does not function at that moment anymore. And up until now, we haven't found any zone that could still produce consciousness, although the cerebral cortex doesn't work anymore. But this is just one aspect. Another aspect is that it seems that these experiences are complete. They really seem, as mentioned before, to reflect what actually happens. They are also partially reparative. Like somebody who is colorblind in his or her body can suddenly see colors. There have also been 7 cases of blind people who were able to see again during a near-death experience, or at least they received some optical impulses and that correlated about-ish with what they had seen. Or also during these envisions of dying, people who suffer from dementia become lucid again during the last few hours of their life for a short period of time. These are indications that we still, when we overcome something as a defect in our brain in this situation and we repair it because we won't need and use it anymore. And there have been other out-of-body experiences where somebody would go somewhere else and they could observe things that wouldn't have been accessible to them anymore. There are those very weird and strange stories, like a daughter, a young woman had an out-of-body experience and she was drawn to her father and she saw him in town buying himself some sweets. And she had always known him as a very health-conscious man. And she questioned him later on, "Did you really do that?" And he'd really done that. Or there was another case where a young woman saw her mother smoking during her near-death experience. That happened in hospital and her mother was really stressed. And her daughter asked her afterwards, "Did you smoke?" And this could be verified. So you've got these strange cases, but they indicate, if you believe them and you don't think that somebody made these things up or that it was a reconstruction, which can happen as well, we can't exclude that. But if we believe these cases, it would indicate that it is possible to leave the body.
Dr. Eberhard, thank you very much for these interesting pieces of information and for this interview.